as this is an international English language testing system powered by IDP to assess the level of candidate. So my name is Ashman and I am heading the speaking of candidate number 110611. So may I have your full name please?
So my full name is Arvind Tukra.
Okay. How can I address you?
So you can call me by my first name, Arvind.
Okay. What do you do for a living?
Recently I done my secondary education and done with my graduation from GNMT Modular Ghana and full and pursued my family business with that to gain some experience in that.
Okay, how long have you been doing it?
So from last 3 to 4 years I am with my father to pursue a family business and gain more and more experience from that.
Can you describe one of your typical working days?
So there are plethora of working days which are known to be as most typical for me. Some days are like a Christmas event would be known to as most busiest day for me due to more demand in the market of my product.
Okay. Now let's talk about haircuts. Do you often change your hairstyle?
From last 4 to 5 years I didn't change my hairstyle because it looks very decent and elegant.
Do you enjoy going to barber shop?
So pardon, can you please speak?
Do you enjoy to going barber shop?
So I visited the barber shop last Sunday, and after 1 month I go to barber shop to do some grooming of my face and my haircut.
Okay, what kind of haircuts did you get as a kid?
A simple haircut I used to get as my father forced me to do that, and I really want to do set my hair to do a spikes, but my father didn't want it.
Okay, do people in your country get a lot of haircuts?
There are a plethora of haircuts that people try to do, and with the changing scenario, with the changing advancements, the people try to do some colors with their hair also, which is known to be as in more trend right now.
Would you like to change the color of your hair?
No sir, I am in love with my hair color and it looks very decent and elegant.
Okay, so let's move to the next part of your speaking. In this I will give you a cue card on which you have to speak for at least 2 minutes.
Okay.
And you will be given with 1 minute for the preparation. In that 1 minute you can make the notes if you want.
Okay.
On this notepad. And this is your cue card and your time of preparation has started. Please start with your topic.
So from last 5 to 6 years, I am regularly using the internet for calling my lot of questions I was having with it. But the most memorable and remembered situation I know that I use the internet to solve my query and all. And when I was in plus two, I was having an assignment which was given by my chemistry teacher. And I need to solve it and do and give them as soon as possible within 2 to 3 days. And with having so much less time, I have to take the help of internet to do surfing related to my presentation and all. The presentation was related to the carbons and hydroxide. And after doing so much of surfing, after seeing all the videos in the YouTube and seeing almost all of the stuff, I had to download the PPT from the internet also only, and downloaded my all of the PPT and all of the stuff from the internet, and it helped me very much. And the PPT includes Grammarly also, which is known to be as a greatest source to help me to fulfill my presentation as soon as possible. And after doing the presentation, I had shown my tutors also related to presentation, that how is the presentation, and they really appreciated. And I was very thankful to the internet that they helped me so much to complete my presentation. And after that, I really get good marks. It was very appreciable. And some more situations are also there, like if I want to learn a new thing and explore some new things, there I need to get to I surf to the internet, which helps me to complete my all queries which I am having.
Okay, thank you. Let's move to the next part of your speaking, which is part 3. How often do most people use internet?
So with the change of scenario, with the advancements of innovation and globalization, the internet is known to be as a basic source for every individual. And if the person is having a small query also, they try to search from the Google and to try to get a solution from it, which helps them to save a time and do a work efficiently and effectively.
How often do you get online?
Full day I am used to do my work, and sometimes for 2 to 3 hours I have to be online to do some of my work, to do some work which is known to be as most important time for me.
Do you think many people waste their time online?
Young teenagers are wasting most of the time in the internet by using social medias like WhatsApp, Instagram, or by making reels in the Instagram, or doing surfing in the Snapchat and sending streaks to everyone, which is known to be as a wastage of time, and they are not concerned about the future, which can be greatest cause in the future.
Are there drawbacks to its overuse?
So there are merits and demerits also, but overusage is always known to be as a drawbacks of everything, whether we are using internet or doing something else.
Okay. So what kind of information people can get from online?
So they can get a plethora of information from online. If they want to learn something, like if they want to cook something, they can search via YouTube to learn all the recipe, which is known to be as the greatest source to learn new things and explore as much as it's possible.
How has this changed the way that people get their information?
So with the change in advancements, the information they are getting in a very faster way, which is known to be as very helpful for every person to get all the knowledge and skills from the internet only.
What impact does internet have on students?
So there can be a good impact as well, bad impact for the students. If the students are very focused to their career, they try to learn some skills and do some education via various social apps like Byju's, helps them to learn as much as they can. And if they are using their time in social medias, it can cause their future career.
Okay, how will the internet change society in future?
So the internet will definitely change the society in the future, because with the change in everything, if they want to order something or if they want to go somewhere, it always help them. If they want this thing, they can get immediately in few minutes, which can be as greatest impact. And with this changing generation, with this change in times, it can be a greatest impact for the future and for the young people.
Okay, so how people can find a reliable information from the internet?
Pardon, can you repeat?
How people can find reliable information on the internet?
So there are a lot of messengers to get them information. For example, we can surf through Google or Internet Explorer to find the new things and if I want to learn a new thing or I want to know the meaning of the new word, I can only write and get the meaning of that thing.
Okay, thank you very much. It was the end of your speaking interview. Now you can leave.